Now comes the delicate part. Look at that. Bighorn Basics, the life and times of the bighorn sheep. Where do you suppose the sheep are? Don't they come down on schedule every day? Well, the answer to both of those questions is no. The short answer to when: A, when they feel like it. B, most of the time not at all. Only about 30% of the days between May and August will you ever see a sheep down here. Got two toes on it. They can move those toes independently and grab onto things like pieces projecting from the rock. And I'll start another one at the other end. Well, they have the eye sockets. Where are the eyes positioned on the skull? On the sides. What do you suspect that gives them the ability to see?
Almost 360 degrees.
Things all around them. Now they get it. It is made of keratin, like our fingernails. It is different from the antler. These pons, what we call the sheep legs, are known in the geological world as kettle pons. Okay, a kettle is formed when the glacier to fill this valley starts to melt and it leaves big chunks of ice behind. One bleat when I was very near and it was crossing the road. It sounds like it's about to throw up.
Oh, really?
It is very deep and guttural and it's like. That's what a bighorn sheep sounds like. So that makes them strong and hardy. Your typical ram is going to stand about this high at the shoulder and weigh 300. That's all muscle, you know, and bone, and horn. The skull, with all the blood vessels and skin and muscle and horns of a typical ram, is going to weigh about 10% of the total body. We admire bighorn sheep so much that we have adopted them, in many cases, as a symbol. The Rocky Mountain bighorn sheep, Ovis canadensis canadensis, has been adopted as the official symbol of Rocky Mountain National Park and the state of Colorado. And of course, as in many species of wildlife's histories, one of their chief threats to their survival has been us. Because what was happening in 1859 in Colorado? Why were people flocking to come over the Shining Mountains? Not for the scenery, but for something else.
Gold.
Gold! Miners swelled the population of the city of Denver, and a new industry grew up. Because those miners had to be fed, that industry was called market hunting. So hunters came to the mountains and took bighorn sheep, elk, mule deer for their meat so they could sell that meat to the hungry miners. And we have maybe 350 within the park boundary at any given time, divided into five herds. The one that seems to come down here most often are members of the Mummy Herd, named for the Mummy Mountains, where they like to hang out most of the year. There are estimated to be about 90 of those. Other herds whose members you might see, especially if you travel over on Trail Ridge Road, onto the west side, as you come down the road from Alpine Visitor Center, you've made the turn at Medicine Bow Curve. Look off to the west on the slopes of Specimen Mountain. That's